Hello and welcome to the latest Safer Kids Online video log. I'm Robert Lipovsky and today we'll be talking about living in the real world versus the online world. Can you imagine a week without the internet or your mobile phone? Well, children can have an even harder time with such a challenge since they grow up with these two things as such an integral part of their everyday life. Where do you draw the line between a healthy use of the internet and an addiction? Experts argue that it's not so much about how much time the child spends on their device, but what that time is used for. It might be tricky to find the right limit, as even adults get defensive when told they're spending too much time on social networks. So what are the signals suggesting that your child is getting addicted? Number one, be careful if your child gets so immersed in the online world that they lose interest in real life. One extreme example is when the child tries to avoid contact with friends, except through chats, social media, and other digital means. Another sign of trouble is if the time spent in front of their screens is the only time when the child appears to be happy, and any attempt to limit their usage leads to conflict or aggressive reactions. You can use technology such as parental control apps to spot this problem in its early stages. There can also be implications for family life of the child. Living in the virtual world can create a divide between the child and their relatives, and can also lead to difficulties in their social life outside home. While it's not the only factor to consider, increased time spent on social media can be a sign of a developing addiction. Of course, these aren't the only signals attentive parents should watch out for. So what can you do if your child is becoming difficult when the topic comes up? Parents are the primary role models for their offspring, and that includes the use of electronic devices. So if as a parent you're picking up your smartphone every 2 minutes, your child is likely to copy that behavior, creating unhealthy habits. So be a good role model and keep your own digital consumption under control. Never give up on communication. Talk to your child and guide them through the digital environment from day one. It's best to adopt a non-confrontational approach when talking to them about the issue. When the time comes and they ask for more independence, give it to them. But make it clear that you're available to discuss any issue, including potentially disturbing online behavior they might encounter. Build trust and understanding. These are the two essential factors that will ensure your child knows you're the person to turn to if anything bad happens. There's a wealth of good content on the internet. There's also a lot of things that children should not see. We don't want to spy on our children, but it's a good idea to monitor their usage to ensure they're not accessing unhealthy or disturbing content. Teach your kids the necessary balance between the digital and the offline realm. If they like to play games, put it in their schedule, but also organize other leisure activities they will enjoy just as much. For example, suggest they do sports or play a musical instrument and support them in these activities. Plan short breaks from technology. A weekend without a mobile phone or a tablet can be beneficial for both the children and the parents. If you decide to give it a try, prepare a lot of activities that will keep you busy and the technology out of reach. If you feel your child is overusing their device, don't take it away. Instead, suggest practical steps that will help regulate its use. For example, uninstalling some of the social networks or chat apps, or just limiting their notifications can limit the compulsion to look at the device all the time. And last but not least, for a safe online experience, keep track of what your kids do with their devices. ESET Parental Control for Android allows you to limit their online and gaming time, helps you find out what they're up to in cyberspace, and block websites with inappropriate content. Also, it's not a one-way app. Kids can use it to ask for permission to play or browse for longer, or to visit specific websites. That's all for now. Be sure to check out the rest of the Safer Kids Online vlogs with other important and challenging topics. Thanks for watching.